Hey YouTubers, Mike Borders with the Mike Borders Channel. Thank you for watching. Today we're working on our Gravely lawnmower, and in today's video we're going to walk you through the steps on how to properly prepare your lawnmower for long-term storage. Let's get started.
All right, YouTubers in the garage now. In today's video, we're referencing our Gravely ProTurn ZX60 lawnmower. It's a zero turn, and we absolutely love this machine. However, we are going to run you through the simple steps again for long-term storage. And in your operator's manual, they've got it mapped out pretty good. On page 38 of your manual, long-term storage, as you can see here, 5 steps. However, step 1 may be lengthy because you have to perform the short-term storage procedures, which is this whole section here. And for your convenience, we have made a step-by-step video on short-term storage, and that is scrolling above. If you want guidance on that, that may be very helpful. Definitely check that out and then come right back here. And after doing that, step 2, lubricate as directed in maintenance schedule on page 19. This is a pretty neat manual. Once you come to page 19, you have a maintenance schedule here, and you've got all of your recommendations. Check safety interlock system, and on the upper right-hand corner, it states how often they want you to check it, and you have an asterisk or bullet point that corresponds with each item or hour count. For example, check safety interlock system each use, check hydraulic system each use, check parking brake, check engine oil, change engine oil. As you can see here, there's nothing there. Check tire pressure, check mower blades, check battery. That's an every 25 hours item. Clean battery every 25 hours, and check air filter every 50 hours. So again, do your best to follow that maintenance schedule. It's very helpful. Back to page 38. Number 3, touch up all scratched painted surfaces. And I love how they put that in here because they know people like me are going to be driving their mowers, and over time, every now and then, I'm not perfect. I scuff up and hit something along the way, whether it's a rock of the flower bed over there. Scroll in, as you can see here on the opposite side, way out there. I do my best to get pretty close, but I end up cleaning up around the rocks with a string trimmer for safety purposes and to alleviate scratches and dents or dings on my mower deck or any other portion of my mower. And believe it or not, Gravely has a very specific coded color for their mowers, and you can purchase that exact color from the Gravely manufacturer. And it's also possible that the Gravely dealer that you purchased your mower from has that paint as well. So give them a call in the event that you have encountered some scuffs along the summer and you want to touch them up. And it's best to do that before it gets cold, because paint properly sets, dries, and lasts longer when it is applied in warmer weather and in a dry, moisture-free atmosphere. Back to the manual. Step 4, remove and charge battery as directed in battery service on page 23. Store battery in a cool, dry, protected area. Let's talk about the battery real quick. The battery is actually underneath the seat. On the back side, you have that latch here. Shifting it rearward, you'll be able to pull the seat up. I'll need both hands. Again, shifting that lever back, you can carefully shift the seat upward to its resting point. It's also important to make sure that your steering levers are pushed outward to allow the seat to come up and rest. And at this point, you have much better access to everything underneath your seat, such as your gas tank, your fuse box, your parking brake, all the electrical wiring, the fuel line, the fuel filter, etc. And your battery. On the left-hand side, you've got your red positive cable. On the right-hand side, you've got your black negative cable. And this is a 12-volt Duracell battery, and it has a securing plate on the top portion, and that securing plate is held in place by side brackets here. And to loosen up those brackets, you actually have to come down below the lower nuts here, and there's 2 of them. And it's possible just by loosening up one nut, you may be able to come back up top and shift this steel bracket to the side and pull this top plate off, giving you the access to remove your battery. And as far as the bolts and nuts on each, the positive and the negative, it is a 7/16. You wanna remove your negative first and then shift the black cable up and off, and then do it for the positive cable. And then go down below and loosen up that 7/16 nut that I just showed you that secures this side bracket. And after you do that, it's very important, once you get your battery out and removed from your mower, you will want to shift your seat back into the locked position. However, as you do that, very important, make sure you rest and place the negative cable and your positive cable in a safe location, preferably tucked down in where the battery sits and away from the hinges, to alleviate any damage to those cables as you shift that seat into the down and locked position.
Next thing I want to talk about, since you've removed your battery for long-term storage, it's a good time to charge it on a charger. Never, ever, ever charge your battery with your vehicle, meaning never, ever, ever jump start your battery with a car, van, truck, or whatever. Just do not do it. You will cause damage to your battery, and in the event that it is still installed in your mower, not only will you cause damage to your battery, but you can cause additional damage to several components of your lawnmower, and that is not a good way to take care of your mower. So at this point, I will carefully re-secure the seat And I'm not going to take the battery out in this video because we're getting ready for summertime and I just wanted to show you how to take that battery off with the cables and lower nuts to loosen up those side plates to remove that top plate. The last one, store unit in a cool, dry, protected area. Do not store unit outdoors. Obviously, that would not be good. Rain, snow, ice, etc. High winter winds.
You don't want to put your mower through that.
Additional items that we covered in the short-term storage. Again, you can find that link scrolling above the video earlier. And the last thing I want to say is I'm a firm believer in the cleaner you keep your machines, whether it's a mower or snowblower, the longer they will last. So that's it, YouTubers. Hopefully this video helps. Do us a favor below the video. You'll see that thumbs up icon. Click on that, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely ring your YouTube bell. That would be awesome and very helpful to us. Thanks again for watching.